React, Angular, Knockout.js, Vue.js, Svelte. I would say these are the most popular modern JavaScript UI frameworks. But wait, did I just say Knockout.js? Okay, I admit it, Knockout does not really belong on this list. But a few years ago, Knockout was pretty hip. I worked with it for a couple of years on a fairly large project, so I think it's safe to say that I have some experience. And at that time, when I started with Knockout, I loved it because I had very little experience in web development and I only knew things like jQuery. So developing with Knockout was a whole new experience for me. But over the years, the project grew, I learned a lot about web development, I evolved, I learned React, and so today I'm happy when I don't have to work on Knockout.js code anymore. And I will tell you why. And before we start, this video is not meant for Knockout bashing, I just want to share my thoughts and experiences with you. But what actually is Knockout.js and what are its strengths? Knockout.js is an open source JavaScript library that helps you build responsive web applications. It implements the MVVM pattern and allows two-way data binding between the Vue, which is the HTML page, and the Vue model, which contains all your logic. Data binding means that you have a property in your Vue model that represents some kind of data or setting, and you bind it to an UI element. When that property, called observables in Knockout, is changed, the corresponding part in the UI is automatically updated. And if the value is changed in the UI, the observable is automatically changed as well. One of the biggest strengths is that it is really easy to get started. You just have to load Knockout.js file and you're ready to go. No bundler like Webpack or anything else is needed. After that, all you need to do is create a Vue model with some observables and bind those observables to UI elements in your HTML page. Very simple. As I said, these bindings are bidirectional, called two-way bindings. You update the observable, the UI updates automatically. You update the UI, the observable updates automatically. You can also subscribe to changes in such observables so that you are notified when a value changes and can perform specific tasks when that happens. If you're interested in the other features or a deep dive into Knockout.js, check out the website because, as I already said, with the years I got more and more unhappy with Knockout. But why? Well, there are several reasons. One is the observables themselves. On the one hand, you can say that, as practical as they are always causing some gray hairs because the observables are not normal JavaScript variables. They are basically functions that provide this under-the-hood UI update magic that makes them harder to read while debugging. I also often had the problem of not being sure if a variable I was working with was an observable or a normal JavaScript value. Sometimes I even managed to have an observable inside an observable, so things got really wild. But it gets really uncomfortable when you're not just working with a few observables containing simple values. For example, you need to work with a complex object. Let's say an object that stores data about a person. And say you have a list of such persons and you want the list to be observable, but also the individual properties of each person. Then you have to convert all those properties and the list itself into observables. There is a Knockout extension that handles this conversion, but it still makes things quite complex because you always have to think about this conversion between plain JavaScript objects to observables and vice versa, and that can get quite tricky. And if you think about this example with the list of people where each person has properties that are also observables and the list has a lot of entries, you might get severe performance issues because every observable comes with a cost. The more observables, the worse the performance. Another problem with observables is that whoever has access to an observable can update the UI. This may sound weird since this is the whole idea behind observables, but I have learned that this can also lead to problems because you may have trouble finding out exactly what caused the UI to update, especially if you pass an observable to a function or another component. Then, good luck tracking down the piece of code that makes an unwanted change to your observable. something I never really liked but still did regularly because I just had to, was writing knockout code inside HTML commands. And if you have never worked with knockout, this may sound strange, but yes, this is normal in knockout. For example, if you want to create a for each loop to create a div or any HTML element for each entry of an array, but you do not have a Barrett container where you can place the data bind, you can do this inside such HTML commands. The problem is, this stuff makes the code much less readable, because syntax highlighting never really worked for me here and you had no indentation of the child elements. Also, matching a start element with its end element can sometimes be tricky, especially when you have nested blocks with such HTML commands. I have said it several times, knockout data bindings are two-way bindings, bi-directional bindings if you will, and that is great, but sometimes it's not. It has happened to me many times that the UI has caused an update of the bound observable, even though no change has been made. For example, I used select2, a jQuery-based select box, bound it to an observable, had a subscribe to that observable that set another observable. But for whatever reason, the select2 triggered a change on the observable, which caused the subscribe function to be executed, so the other observable was changed even though it should not have been set. And I had situations like that all the time, and it certainly caused me some gray hairs. Another thing I don't like about knockout is that you have to write a lot of code in strings whenever you use the databind attribute on an HTML element, which you will do all the time with knockout because that's how it works. I mean, it looks pretty ugly, you have no syntax highlighting, you have no code completion, so not the best developer experience. Also, it is not that unlikely that you will end up adding some logic to those databind attributes, which makes it even uglier, and you're scattering logic all over your HTML files. Whenever it came to creating or debugging a custom binding handler, I got a headache. To be honest, I never understood it 100%, and what always bothered me was the fact that although knockout follows a declarative approach with the observables and data bindings, which is actually one of the key concepts of knockout, you still have to access and manipulate HTML directly via JavaScript or jQuery, which is a bit of a contradiction if you ask me, so I always was a bit skeptical, you know? Splitting code into separate, reusable parts is basically possible in Knockout.js, but it is also something that never seemed very convenient to me. The syntax is pretty cumbersome, so you are not likely to extract your reusable parts of your code, so you end up with duplicate code, huge view models, and hard to maintain code, especially in larger projects. In React, for example, I constantly look at my components and see if it makes sense to take parts of my component and extract them into separate components, and that doesn't seem to be as easy in Knockout.js. And last but not least, Knockout does not seem to be actively maintained for some time now, which does not really make it a good choice for new projects. So, to summarize, even though Knockout has some good approaches in this really lightweight and easy to integrate, I think in most scenarios you should not consider using it anymore. The alternatives that exist today simply offer better packages. Okay, that's it for this video. What do you think of Knockout.js? Have you ever used it? Have you even heard of it? Let me know in the comments. If you liked this video, please click the like button and subscribe to my channel if you don't want to miss future videos. Thanks for watching. Bye.